All right, so we have a situation right now, right? Just got back from the gym maybe like an hour or two ago, just released my video, just banged that out, and it's about to take a shower. And I'm taking my shirt off, right? So I'm kind of going back here to take it off, and then I notice some shit is glued to some shit. My scab is literally glued to my shirt. Can I just rip it off?
I mean, that's just gonna hurt.
How bad is it? What? How bad is
Hold
it?
on, don't touch it. As you guys can see, it's
Oh,
stuck.
is it bad?
I
How,
mean,
what is it stuck with? Blood, sweat, voodoo magic? What is it?
you got that shit. See where that it
Dude.
probably got like the scab probably got moist from you sweating in the gym and like when you like leaned
Jesus
against your
Christ.
chair to do
Is it
your
stuck
video.
here too?
No.
All right, it's just over there. All
It's
right,
because
cool.
when you sat in your chair after you edited, it probably stuck and you were there for so long.
Yo, Chris, make this shit moist. Make it moist. People don't like the word moist, do they? Make it moist.
It
Come
makes
on.
people very uncomfortable.
Yeah, and like dip it down there.
Yeah, right? I have a movable hose at the top. You can fucking grab that shit and shove your back under. Don't pull the fucking don't pull.
I know.
I was
I'm
gonna
putting
say.
my weight on it. Fuck.
Do you want me to just?
This is some James Bond shit. Come on. Come on. It's not fucking budging. It's on. Come on. All right, the water's getting warm. Let's go.
Yeah. Oh yeah. That's just not gonna get too hot.
Oh no! It's coming off. It's coming off. It's coming off. Oh, I feel it. Ah! Look at that.
Told you.
Let's see what this shit looks like.
I mean, let's see your scab.
Oh. Dude, how does the back look in general? Is it just like, did it heal?
I mean, it's a little more beat. It's still beat up, but.
You know how hard it is for me to sleep at night? It's so hard. You have to take so much Advil, twist and turn. It's not a fun time. James,
Dude, what's
how to feel to play second in the IPF?
to a Canadian.
You lost to a Canadian?
Yeah, drinking his maple syrup. I told you that.
Oh
half a
no.
kilo, 605 versus 605.5.
That's very disappointing. Well, you got some hardcore pre-workout, from what I
Dude, that's some
understand.
hardcore
Dude,
pre-workout.
I've been saying for
You're
the
about
past
to
hour, dude. Look,
experience it. What did you even say for the past
I'm like,
hour?
dude, come on, take this pre-workout. You're sitting here slouching on the
Get
couch
the
and shit.
fuck out of here. Here's some
Opposite.
pre-workout.
Where's it at?
I still no. I can't show the my Powerlifts Federation. I'll get banned.
What? Nah,
Get
dude,
banned.
they won't
This
be watching
has
this,
no
dude.
DMAA in it. This is all IPF legal stimulants.
Doesn't this have the NupTeps and the Higamine or whatever? NupEpt, which is like an alpha neurotropic. So you're just taking a scoop of that?
This is yours.
Dude,
I'm gonna
I don't
have to
want to take
pour
half
my.
of each, dude. I want to
Oh
take just the whole.
no, what is this?
Is
Fly!
there? Let me see
You
that.
know how euphoric this fly is
Let me
right
see
now?
it.
Do you have any
Let me see it.
idea?
Oh, but let it focus.
This fly just had the trip of its life before it perished. It OD'd on DMA. You're gonna have to pour some Drano down there. Make sure that fly doesn't come back to life and kill you.
Fuck.
Alright, I need new water.
No, we just mix it. It's easy. We just do it in the solo cup, dude.
Oh, right.
Wait, so I'm confused. You want to take half of that and then half of that?
Yeah.
Why? Isn't this one the shit though? Why don't I just take a full scoop of the shit?
Well, because this. Look at this.
I want the full serving of
So they
NupTep.
both got. Well, then take a scoop of this and a half scoop of this.
Dude, I'm not no st-
Don't even tell me you're not some stimulant fiend. I know you are for a fact.
Let me see this shit.
You're gonna be all sideways, dude.
1-3, not DMMA. Yeah, that's in here.
Not DMMA.
No, I'm going full scoop of this.
You're going
That's it.
full scoop?
Yeah,
You're gonna
I'm going.
die. You're gonna die just from the taste. Your taste buds are gonna murder
Is it
you.
that bad?
They're gonna be so unhappy with
I'll just
what you
mouth
just
fuck
did.
it, dude.
Okay,
I'll mouth
you're gonna mouth fuck it. Is this filming right now?
Yeah, shit's wrecking.
Then I want YouTube to watch you attempt to mouth fuck this pre-workout. It's the best
Hey.
effect, the worst taste
Hey.
of all time.
My mom told me I could do anything I set my mind to.
Alright. She never.
Fat scoop.
That's a full scoop. Your mom never saw this coming, though. She wasn't aware that you'd have to try something this horrible.
Here, I got your chaser.
No. If you taste
it,
if you taste it, you won't do that.
Yeah, hey, will.
No, you won't.
You're gonna back out. Like, you think I'm gonna back out?
Yeah, you're gonna back out. Like,
come on. Hey, it's just a little sour. It's kind of sweet at the end. What are you talking about?
Do it. Go for it.
Let me sit in this chair.
Yo, we're switching spots.
Okay. You ready? Now, there's a way to finesse this.
You got it.
The other day,
I'm gonna get pumped just for your pre-workout. Let's
go. The other day, I almost you doing this with ESP. There's a certain way you have to do it, right?
Do you want?
No, I got.
You gotta wrap. But open your mouth wide. You gotta.
No, wait.
You gotta make sure it doesn't.
No, James, I'm a fucking professional, James. Just let me take care of this. I need my concentration.
Alright.
Dude, am I gonna uke?
No. No. Here's what you do. You take it, you chase it, and then you go ham. Like, you can't just sit there and let it sizzle. You have to, like, get
it up. It sizzles? This fucking sizzles!
No, I mean sizzle in your stomach, you know? Like, you can't think about the fact that the free workout's in there. You gotta get up and be like, yeah! And just get pumped.
Alright, you got this.
Come on. That was smooth.
Look at me, James. It's done.
All right, not bad, not good. But it was. It didn't taste good. Don't even tell me that.
Dude, it doesn't even taste bad. What do you mean? This shit does not taste bad. What are you talking
about?
You're
flexing for YouTube.
Damn, I was getting ready to turn battery acid, dude. Like.
Well, good. That's probably why it didn't taste bad.
So you're just gonna take half a scoop of each?
Yeah. I gotta diversify my chemicals, which contain not DMAA.
You're one of them Yohembine thoughts, aren't you?
I think that's banned too.
You take it? Look like you're having a hard time over there.
I am having a hard time.
Eat. After you take your pre-workout, what do you mean?
You're talking to the IPF champion almost.
Okay, IPF champion doesn't change the laws. If you put a Pop-Tart in your stomach goes from just digesting your pre-workout, which is going to hit you right away.
Look at the volume of this food.
Okay.
It's basically two-dimensional. It's gonna be digested. All right,
but
fast. Enzymes are just gonna cling on to either side.
Dude, Bob, it literally by a hair, by a fucking hair, it enters the third dimension. So it's gonna slow the absorption of your pre, dude.
All right, loser gains then.
Oh.
Oh, I can't find my wrist wraps, dude.
You need wrist wraps to bench, dude. What's up?
Well, when I'm holding such a brutally heavy weight, like I know.
Like 225. When he came last night, let's look at this shit. He had like.
Technologically advanced.
He had like
so. No,
literally.
I'll give a quick rundown. With a normal lever belt, you have to have a screwdriver. You need to literally have utilities on you so you can set it to the right, you know.
Yeah.
Width, and then once it's there, some days you might have eaten more. You're gonna be a little bit fatter. You're gonna be like maybe drank tons of water, and you won't even be able to clasp this thing. But SBD came around. With their rocket engineers, and they
hashtag
made it.
Neil deGrasse Tyson.
So this part of it is set in place. You can't move it, and the part that you actually hook it onto has a bunch of different holes. So instead of having to unscrew it, I can either choose to hook it here, or choose to hook it here, or choose to hook it down here.
But that still doesn't change the issue that it pinches you when you put
it
on.
It doesn't. If yes. You learn a little bit of abdominal manipulation.
Listen, I'm not Frank Zane over here. I can't be doing no vacuums.
Vacuum it. And then, so you pinch the bottom part of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
You pinch it, do a vacuum, pull up.
Ugh, it looks like you're having a tough time. The moral of the story is...
Moral of the story is, I got it on.
And it took him, he almost melted my SD card to get it on, right? But the intra-abdominal pressure is better with your prong belt. Get a prong belt. Don't
get a prong belt. If you want to make gains, get the SBD lever belt. Don't touch my camera.
Okay, top comment right now, description box. Lever belt versus prong. By the way, if you guys want me to like you, prong.
Here we go. All
right.
Put it on.
Okay, shit's
now, put on. Put on this setting. This, because that's where it would be. You got like the same size waist as me.
Alright.
Or no, you can do one more.
No, I'm just gonna test it out. Alright, okay, so I'm pinching it.
So vacuum, there you go. No pinching. No pinching is going on here.
Alright, wait, hold on.
You're good. You just gotta pull that up. Pull the bottom up.
Oh, okay.
So, see that smile there? That's the smile of someone who's hooked on the lever belt. Oh, so nice. Wait, all so the intra-abdominal pressure just disappears.
So my only concern...
You don't need to sit there with your dumbass prong belt and get up to some power rack and, like, hold it on the side and pull out the prongs. You don't need to do that. You just
flip it off. Wait, did this shit come right away when you ordered it, or it took, like, forever, like, the ends or
I bought it at a booth at Worlds. There was just an SBD booth, and I was like, yo, I'm actually an SBD athlete.
Are you an SBD athlete?
I was for Worlds. They sent me a bunch of free shit. Like that. This right here. It's my singlet. Team USA singlet.
Shit. Yo, I'm going Dallas right now, dude. I'm spoiling myself. Oh, man, I miss that so much, dude. That helps me so much.
I give you access. If you want to squat tomorrow. Yeah. No, you're pulling tomorrow. Yeah, we can trade off with that belt, and see, we can do that because it's adjustable.
Is this 10 millimeter?
13,
it's
I 13? Think. I think so.
Wait, does that okay? Do you feel like 13 helps you more than 10?
You don't notice a difference. Well, I don't know if it's because of the thickness, but dude, wearing my Inzer now, it might be because it's just more worn in, and like I've just worn it for like 2 years now, but. It's literally like I'm wearing some dumb little, like, cloth belt when I put my Inzer on. So I literally only wear it for bench now.
It doesn't, like, in a lot of, like, federations, they don't allow, like, 13 mils.
I don't know. I know.
If 13 helps more, I don't give a shit. I'll buy a 13 belt, dude. I want every pound I can get.
IPF allows it because they literally sold it. IPF,
dude. Just scared the shit out of me.
God damn.
My trash can't open in the kitchen.
Okay.
I'm ordering this belt 13 mil, literally.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry, you're ordering the lever belt? Wait. No, Dave. Dave.
I'm gonna put it in note to self. Fuck, dude, I like this so much. Fuck!
It's dude, solid, isn't it? Dude. Just feel... Okay, just listen. Does this have some good acoustics on it? Just listen. Oh, wait, so nice.
Wait. Zoom in on the... No, wait. Here, get it. Ooh. Get it up close and personal. Ready? Listen. Hold on. Listen to this shit. Ready? I'll fight Pete Rubish any day. I really won't.
He will not do that. He's not going to fight Pete Rubish.
Dude, Pete Rubish,
we like you. We don't want any beef.
Pete Rubish, actually, he was just at that gym that we're going to Attila's. He was literally just there.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you see him?
No, I didn't see him. Rich Piana was there, too. I didn't see him.
Rich Piana's, dude, isn't he like, he's dying.
I'm fucking telling me, dude. I'm so getting a 13 mil belt. So long story short, like, do you feel like you're more alpha with this belt? Like, you feel like you...
I just feel like I can just, you know, walk around like a fucking dominant male in my SPD belt.
Makes you
feel
like you got a third cock?
A third cock?
Yeah, oh, dude, the belt helps so much. I'm pulling 675 on this tomorrow. I'm not even kidding.
Okay. You're just gonna skip right over the 650 milestone.
Dude,
just go right to
650 milestone, dude. In my body, with my leverages, my setup with a Texas deadlift bar.
With my leverages. With my leverages. I'm just like naturally fucking strong as fuck, everybody.
I can pull any weight you put on the bar if nothing snaps on sumo deadlift.
Dude, we're like the exact same height with the stance. It's nice. Just walk around like that. I'll feel better.
675 tomorrow.
How's the Inzer feel now?
Dude, it's not even a belt, dude. What is
this? It's just a piece of cloth. It's literally just a piece of cloth I wear on bench to push my ribs up.
Dude, this is just something. This is honestly considered beltless, to be honest. It's just fashionable, dude.
Yeah, you should. Exactly. It's just a fashion statement. You can say that you pulled or squatted beltless if you wear an Inzer belt. Like, that's just how it is.
It feels so much more powerful.
The
SBD, dude.
SBD.
Wait, you know what? You might have not gotten any beta-alanine. I don't know if there's any beta-alanine.
I don't fuck with beta-alanine.
All right, fine then.
All right.
where are we gonna go right now, right?
Rock bottom.
Holy shit. We're gonna rock bottom.
that is free workout talking. When you're going like this, it's
trying
not
to
budging.
Rip your carbs out of water. See, now, you might ask, where, I don't know if you can see, because the GoPro is a super wide angle lens. You might be like, where's James's car? How did James get here? You wanna tell him what happened, James?
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, wait, there's a GoPro going? I didn't realize we were.
Who do you think I was talking to?
Oh, yeah, well, that's why I asked. It's a 6-hour drive to get to Dave's house. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to college orientation. I'm already going to be driving like an hour south. So I just figured I'll drive another 5 hours south. Anyway, 4 hours and 15 minutes down, my transmission literally explodes on the highway. Like, it literally exploded. That is not an exaggeration at all. I pulled over. I was maintaining like 6,000 RPMs, doing 70 miles an hour. So I pulled over, and there's just steam pouring out of there. And yeah, my car is gonna have a straight up funeral in New Jersey. Like, I'm not even close to home. There's nothing I can do.
Is James in stock? Yes, he is.
Different James. Rock bottom James. Drug dealer James.
But yeah, the reason we stopped by rock bottom is because we need to get some chalk, because James is like, I'm a fucking IPF, I need all my IPF, shit to be home, dude, like, yeah. This. So.
And I've never been to rock bottom, and this is like the rock. Isn't Island Gym somewhere
Shit's
around here?
Literally right there, that's Island Gym.
Didn't you get like excommunicated from that place?
Yes, I got permanently banned from Island.
Why? I forget why. Hard like dropping part. Weights and shit, wasn't it about like being, you were just something displaying like your masculinity to the mortal masses, and they didn't like that. We're up to get our real chalk.
Yeah.
James!
How you doing?
How's it going?
Yo.
Is everything good, James?
This is How are you? I'm James.
Oh, shit!
Nice meeting you. Whoa. It's crazy.
The clash of the Jameses. Now, James, word on the street is right.
Only one. Oh, okay.
Word on the street, James, is that this joint sells chalk. Is this true?
Is this true?
Guys, you have to be a little bit bigger to buy this chalk.
Oh,
this is better.
Just combine the both of us.
If we just stay really close together, we'll appear.
Our fat free mass indexes add up to like, yeah. I don't know, 10,000. So just like,
this one.
Dave, how much is this shit?
You can just give me $2. It's fine.
All right, cool. Wait, James, do you have a pre-workout called like Dusk or something?
Dusk Extreme.
I feel like you would definitely have some shit like that, James.
He's hiding it from me.
James,
you.
I know you have it.
You've got to stock.
I know you have it, James. Let's not play games here, James.
You've
where is it?
Stocked in the bag.
Why is it better?
It has Nuke Tapped in it. And 75 milligrams of 1.3.
Screw the ingredients. If you look at the actual graphics, they're demons with like lasers coming out of their eyes. Dude, it's a
like
good food workout.
It's like the God of Rage was.
I'm not even kidding. When I just saw this, I thought it said ayahuasca. Did you kind of see it? Kind of like if you're a little bit dyslexic, you just look at it real quick.
And then go into the gym.
Look to my left where?
Ultimate Orange is pretty good.
Wait, James, do you know about the history of Ultimate Orange? This is not the same shit, right? This is
65 milligrams of DMA.
65? What? Okay, do you know Ultimate Orange? This was before Jack 3D. It was literally like the first pre-workout ever, before the genre of pre-workouts even existed.
Dude,
and it had
you can
like
tell just by how simplistic the graphics are. It's literally just an orange.
Yeah, no, it had ephedrine in it, and that was the shit back in the day.
Did they take it out? Wasn't that like banned by the FDA or something?
No, yeah, ephedrine was like mega banned. 1.3 is kind of like a little banned. No big deal.
1.3 has been on and off. The FDA's like, it's pretty bad for you.
Whoa! How did you manage to do that?
Incline bench. I have a 1x5 with 230. Fuck that, dude. I'm not doing that. I'm
one set of five.
It's so stupid.
I'll do.
I'm gonna rep out 225.
Didn't you say you can do that with me? Didn't you say you can get it for like 12? Why would you do 230 for fucking five?
Because this is my coach. He's just thinking like a powerlifter. There's no body dysmorphia or like anything like that coming into play.
Someone left a comment on my last video. It was the funniest thing, because I was talking about how like my back's all snapped up. I'm like, yeah. Oh, Dave, like, we hope you get better, because we know the flat bench is where your heart truly lies. I fucking died when I read that.
I mean, dude, think about anyone who's into like physique, their incline is usually almost matches their flat, because you know that upper chest, the sexual upper chest, and then you get all these power lifters with droopy tits because they only care about flat bench with a huge arch, so it's just all lower back.
For me, when I'm full time like flat bencher, my incline is just astronomically weaker, just like, yeah, so much weaker. But yeah, like someone who is more of like a physique competitor that doesn't really have like a very powerful RG setup or anything.
Yeah.
They just kind of lay with a flat back and just do all the, for me, pushing movements, like maybe like overhead press and just like incline bench movements, I kind of go up rather than kind of like the arms perpendicular to the body. Like it really blows
the triceps.
Up.
No, yeah,
my long
dude.
Head and my tries just get blown up and I get
definitely.
So much stronger.
But dude, if you, last training block, I literally only did close grip every single day. Every single time I benched, I only did close grip, and now we're transferring back to competition grip, and my lockout is just bam.
Yeah.
It just locks out so quickly because my triceps are just blown up.
We have, this gym has like a bunch of shitty bars, like Toys R Us shiny little shit bars that they bought as exploits.
But you have good ones too.
They have my
bar. Is there a Texas deadlift bar?
There's a Texas deadlift bar, a Texas power bar, and the Rogue Ohio bar, which is mine.
Rogue Ohio bar. Oh, you bought that?
Yeah, that was from my home gym.
If I'm feeling real good and I pull 585 on the deadlift bar, I might YOLO 585.
Here's what you gotta do. Here's what you gotta do. One
it's
plate,
hard
two
to
plate,
grip.
Three plate, four plate, five plate, six plate. Just like that. Just like that.
I don't know.
No funky 520 on none of that shit. Count up the plates. That's how it's done. Trust me. Trust me.
Yeah, but the intensity, dude. I've learned how to make 495.
For me, what I firstly noticed on the deadlift, right? For like my sumo deadlift maxing, me getting psyched up, it's actually a negative because I'll lose focus on certain mental cues. And I'll just come in with a huge general. So I've noticed for me, like when I pulled my 635, like my 585, everything working up to the 635 and the 635 itself, just kind of come up and just pick it up. Just stay very calm, collected, focus on your form, and just pull it. And literally, that works better for me than getting psyched up.
I can't stay cool, calm, and collected and pick up 585. I need to get hyped up, but I need to get hyped up thinking about the form. Just be hyper-focused on, like,
There's definitely a balance and a right way to do it. You can't just get so just, like, psyched up that your fucking primitive instincts take a pick up weight. Like you have to,
I've gone for 585 and just gotten wicked hyped up, and I ripped it off the floor. Then it got to my knees, my back was rounded, and, like, everything was just wrong. So I know the kind of the general balance, but I need the actual general strength, too, as part of it. The fitness mecca. I don't know if I believe that. I'm bringing in my
old
dude,
you're like a proper old school bodybuilder, dude.
I'm dead.
What'd you do?
Pulled at a 4x10 on deadlifts.
What'd you do?
Max. I had 315 for 4x8.
All right. Conventional or sumo?
Conventional.
All right, good shit.
See how it feels. Pain. That's a personal rocket ship right there.
Let's just do a single on flat.
All right.
That's
a YouTube single right there. All right.
This is straight cheat code powerlifter.
this is some bullshit.
We got a right arm rubber match right now going on. It's for bragging rights, boys. Dave, you ready?
Where's your bag? Where's your backpack?
He's getting this chocolate chip, dude. He's gonna help him. He's gonna chocolate happy games.
I just wanted to be fair. I just don't want to slip. Oh, fuck.
We don't got the straps, dude. This ain't no Devin Lair, John Brzezinski. Actually, we're all friends here, right? Right? I'm awake now.
So much for going to bed.
Chris, I ain't no mathematician, but what is this?
Three out of four.
We got boost aboard number one. Boost aboard number two. James English.
Wait, no, I don't have all of my meals on the table. You gotta wait.
What do you mean?
I still have French toast coming.
Fuck. Alright, just pretend there's French toast
French
right
toast
there.
Right here.
Pancakes. Breakfast Grand Slam coffee because he's addicted to coffee. Hashtag crackhead. And here's one, two, three huge plates for me.
Because after this. You think he's gonna eat all that? Dave.
Listen, we need to look at this LOC hype right here. Legacy over currency. Chris Lamar.
Trying to change the subject. He's not gonna eat all that food.
Listen, the moral of the story is I'm gonna eat all this food with all these carbs and all this sodium, right? Because within maybe like 5-6 hours, we're gonna go to the gym. I'm gonna pull 6 plates. I mean, 7 plates, at least.
No.
I think you're gonna pull 6 plates.
He'll get through maybe this. He'll poke around at that with his fork. He won't actually put any of the pancakes into his mouth. He might eat like a French fry. He might take the toothpick out of his burger.
I got chocolate milkshake coming too.
Which he's not gonna drink. He basically got food for the entire day, but he's fronting.
Watch me. I'm not even hungry now, but I'm still gonna fucking eat it. Watch me. We have Jason English, aka James English, doing some sneaky serial killer shit right here with his thumbnails. Please elaborate on what's happening. This is something to do with hook grip.
Yeah, well, I feel like I was just feeling like sumo wasn't cheating enough, so I switched over to hook grip, and I felt like hook grip wasn't cheating enough, so I started grooving my thumbnails. Like, I don't know if the camera can see it.
Let me see this.
See my musty.
Oh, you fucking! I'm all zoomed in. Calm the fuck down, huh?
See that?
Let me see. Uh-huh. Wait, let me focus. Wait. It's goddamn F4 shitty son. Yeah, I see it.
Yeah. So you can see that's literally like the knurling on a bar, but on my thumbnail. Because hook grip, you're literally grabbing over your thumb. So like, if there's knurling on there, you're gonna be able to grip better.
Me, on the other hand, I don't need any of that bullshit. The Texas bar.
He doesn't
the
need
sumo
any
stance.
Of that bullshit to fail 675. He doesn't need
it's
any.
It's cheater
of that.
Enough for me, right? So, and things, my hands are just absurdly massive, even for my 6'3 frame. So, with a reverse grip, I don't really have any issues grabbing onto the bar. But being double overhand on sumo is an advantage over under, especially compared to conventional, because when both your hands are over, right, your torso could be so much more upright, your hips are so much closer to the ball, your lats are so tight.
A way better position.
Yeah, you're starting.
It's so nice. And people think you're pulling double overhand. They don't realize you're pulling hook
grip.
They
think you're alpha
as
fuck.
So then you just get like hella bitches.
But yeah, double overhand for a sumo definitely helps a lot. But for me, I just kind of, I don't know, my over underhand grip, I have some type of ego tie down into like being like alpha, not using any straps, not using hook grip.
I'm wearing Gymshark right now, so you gotta help me take this sweatshirt off. It's too tight. It won't
get
over my
kidding?
Massive frame. I'm serious. Help me, come on.
How is it? God damn. Making me burn all my glycogen before I start my shit.
Sabotaging your 675, which you wouldn't hit anyway.
Yeah, I told myself I'm gonna hit 675 today, but if we run.
But-
what butt?
James, I listen. I'm hyping you up when I say listen, you're a fail. I'm not serious. The last time I even remember doing sumo is the other day when I did 405 for some sets of five.
Dave, what were you just saying to me? Oh, the best program for me is taking off like months from deadlifting and then going back and pulling 800. The best program for him is literally just taking time off. Like, if he trained sumo deadlift, he would lose poundage on the lift. I'm not even kidding.
So funny, but so true. But yeah, the reason that works for me is because that time off heals up all my snap action. So then no snap action equals strong body equals I'm able to re-snap on a heavy weight, and that's what I do.
Imagine how OP you'd be if not only did you have no snap action, but you could also actually reinforce the motor path.
Right? And I could actually train it, dude. That's just, that's some world record 1,000 pound
you
shit.
You can't have everything, though.
God damn. But yeah, so my back's a little stiff with this little back injury, kind of coming back a little bit from one of my previous squat sessions. Hips feel like a little, the adductor muscles feel kind of like a little sore-ish, but I'm going to take a very long warm-up protocol, do a little bit of stretching, kind of get on the treadmill a little bit, get some blood flowing on that, and yeah, we'll see what happens.
My squats. I got to do squats so I can learn how to use quadra.
You think you're better than everyone because you squat 465?
Nah, I feel like I'm better than everyone that squats sub 465.
Yeah.
So we're going to start off.
This is for you. What are you taking?
No, I'm making a drug concoction.
Hold on. I have heavy say in this shit. Because I know ESP works real well, and what I was considering.
Well, I'll put some ESP in there then. I wasn't going to overload you. I'm literally just increasing the amount of different chemicals that you're taking. Listen, that way you'll be stronger.
No, listen. Here's what I'm going to do. Here's what I'm thinking. A good portion of ESP, okay? Decent amount of ESP. I got straight 1-3 dimeth pills. Like straight up.
I don't care. It's not real dimeth.
Yes, it is.
No, you got scammed.
Jeez, why don't you just do your stack first. Just do your stack first, and then you'll fill me, and then we'll decide all right, my stack
together. I'm stealing some of your ESP.
Alright.
Is this the OG ESP?
I don't have a non-OG ESP. What do you think this is?
What the fuck? This is so light. Why is it sealed? Or is this just, it just comes straight off.
Is there anything in there? Whoops. Let me see. Yeah.
Oh, nostalgia. A nice little energy crusties. So I'm only gonna take like a quarter of a scoop of this because I haven't taken in a while. I don't want to shock my body with any.
What do you mean you don't want to shock your body? That's exactly what you want to do. You want to take shit that you're used to?
Because I'm gonna take some other shit too.
Your other shit you're used to.
I take some Irie.
Oh my god.
Yeah, some of that.
This is some bullshit stack right here.
It's a good stack. I don't want to OD on fucking pre-workout, because then you get too hyped, you go up to the bar, you're not even thinking about form, you just rip it off the ground, your back rounds, can't lock it out.
Sounds like a bunch of bullshit, James.
Sounds like something that you said word for word yesterday.
Listen, James, hey, that was yesterday. Shit doesn't count anymore. It's a disassociation with the past. Forget about it, we're all friends here.
Oh, I'm about to make this whole thing taste so bad. With one little half scoop.
See how you're diversifying a bunch of chemicals? Mm-hmm. You're just getting, alright, instead of loading on one good chemical that works, you're just taking a small, shitty, useless dose of a bunch of shit chemicals.
They're not shit chemicals.
Okay, they're great chemicals, but in low doses, they're shit and they don't do anything.
How can I trust anything you say if you contradict yourself within two sentences?
Hey,
we're not even listening.
Hey,
we're not all friends here.
We're all friends here, dude. Yo, hey. What color is this shit?
Well, I guess he's gonna, I don't know.
You gonna put creatine in there too? Why are you putting creatine?
Because I take creatine.
Don't take it now.
That's what makes me out total you, Dave.
Oh my god. Fucking shit. Only scumbags mix their shit with a fork.
Only scumbags literally only carry plastic forks in their
house. Hey. We're all friends here.
Well, first, let's just soak in the nice color.
That's actually, that is a nice color.
Some nice chemical color. That's exactly what I want. I didn't mix my creatine.
James, your creatine
with the fuck? I'm mixing my creatine in there. I'm taking it like an
alpha. Creatine has no acute effects. Why are you taking it, James? Listen. Is that fork upside down? Mm-hmm. That's how serial killers do it.
Alright, hold on. Let's make this dramatic.
excuse me. Ooh.
You know what I'm taking today? I'll tell you what I'm taking.
You're taking an L on that 675.
Yeah, that's Michael. Yeah, look, that's Michael. What's up?
Yeah.
That's creepy as shit. But here, point the shit back at me. Alright. This dusk is dusk.
Dusk. Dusk. You're not allowed to take it. You just. Dusk. Listen. We're all friends here.
Listen, man. Dusk extreme, right? Let's look at the alpha chemicals in here. It has NewTept, which makes all focus and shit.
Yeah.
N13.Math, 30 milligrams of NewTept, 75 13.Math, right? I'm taking half a scoop straight to the dome. It's going to be mouth fucked.
Is it really a half scoop?
Something like that.
Let's see. Yep. Now it looks a little bit high. A little bit illegitimate.
Oh, Chris, I was just telling them all these beautiful chemicals that I'm taking to pull an outrageous amount of weight, okay? I'm going to take two little ESPs.
Two little ESPs.
And one full power.
Why don't you just fill up the big scoop halfway so you can do it all at once?
James, you're a very intelligent young man.
Actually, it's three. It's two-thirds.
No, here's what you do. You get another scooper for the ESP and you just put two scoops.
He just got beat.
Oh, wait, what? Wait, what just happened?
Put two small scoops in the big scoop of another scooper.
Dude, this is a...
I don't like
ton of drugs, dude. I don't know if I want to condone this.
What do you mean you don't want to condone this? Hey, grab this camera.
I'm sure that's your job to condone this.
Yeah, that's your whole job. You literally get teenagers addicted to drugs like
what?
No!
Not at all.
People
hey.
Watch David Lane, they're like, where do I get DMAA?
Where are you taking, James?
DMAA.
Just DMAA?
DMAA and some other stuff.
I was gonna say, what are the odds you match Dave's stack right now?
Dave, what are you?
Pretty low, but
scoop.
I took another
ESP.
I took a small scoop of ESP, actually it wasn't even filled up all the way, and then a half scoop of dust and a half scoop of irate.
Chris, you know what I'm taking? Watch this shit. Half scoop of this shit. This has 75 milligrams of 1-3 and 30 milligrams of a compound called NewTep. It's like a neurotropic, it makes you very focused, it complements stimulants. It complements stimulants very nicely, okay? Good chemical. Half a scoop of that, two little ESPs, and one of these pills. And the purpose I'm taking this is a little slow release the MMA because it's gonna hit me slightly after all the powder.
You know that if this stuff gives you a heart attack, there's nothing I can do. I know how to perform CPR, it'll be useless. You will be dead.
Yeah. Is this a lot?
This is a lot, dude.
Shit, I'm trying to really think about how much this is.
No, you have to take it now.
How much is this
just
shit?
Try and go to CVS if you can find some Narcan real quick.
This isn't heroin, dude. This is the opposite.
No, Randy,
heroin would help calm me down. Like.
You know it's gonna be a good workout when you gotta bring your defib unit to the gym.
Can I just put out my gym bag?
So, okay, 75. Okay, what's 75 divided by 2? Like 20? Like 30? 30?
Okay,
35.
How much is in the pill?
So like 60 milligrams of 1,3-dimeth.
Yes.
No. How much is in this?
25.
Okay.
So it was 60 milligrams of 1,3.
Something like that. But then there's a clone of 1,3.
I know.
So it's basically 1,3.
But it's
too small. Yeah, it's just too small. Yeah. Hey, you know what, James? You gotta take the measures you need.
I mean, worst comes to worst.
Take the measures you need to take to fail 675.
Probably around like 110,
Of just hardcore 1,3-dimethyl.
Wait, hold on, like, Dave. Dave,
because you gotta think like one small scoop ESP is probably around like 25 milligrams.
Dave, what is that? Is that a lever belt? Hold on, is that a lever belt?
Hey.
Is that my lever belt?
It's a 13 mil belt, hey.
Hey. Right. Hey.
Let's start this shit.
We're friends.
Pill
we're
first.
Friends.
Watch this shit. No, point your shot, man.
Down the hatch. Sassy belt flick.
Do I hate doing this shit?
Aw, you know, feel 675. There you go. He's smiling because of how good it was.
I think he just wants to eat more and more.
Yeah, he's smiling so hard.
Pretty
it was
one
so
of the
good.
Biggest drug stacks I've ever taken. It's from my mock meat video. One big scoop ESP and two.
Dude, this is smashing. The beta alanine complex that I just took is like under my skin, smashing my face up. Here, can you just record for a sec? Cause I gotta finish my
your stack.
My red Zola cup, not DMAA, not IPF banned substances.
Dave's not gonna make it.
What?
You're gonna die the way the gym did.
I will Snapchat you a picture of Michael. Like, guys, I can give everyone your Snapchat on here. You will just get.
Let's go. Oh, he's doing the dust again. You think the ESP was bad?
Gronk spike.
If you watch the tables just be closed, we have to go to fucking Tilt and then pull up the stiff bar and pull 455 for a set of two. I go home and cry. Dude, if it's closed, it's some fucked up holiday today. Today's not the day.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Dude, if that Tilt is closed, we can just go to the woods and kill animals with our bare hands. Dude, we'll literally be like vampires. We're just on another fucking level. Our central nervous system output could just take down a giraffe. You think there's no giraffes around here?
Yeah, I don't think there's any
giraffes
around here.
Not yet. Alright, let's go. I was a guy outside, one guy who blasted out, got pain. Everybody watch now, everybody watch. Everybody get down, everybody drop. She's seen MCs getting framed with a cop shot.
I don't want that shit, I just want the soundtrack. What the fuck?
Yeah.
tell them why you're a failure at life.
Tell them
why?
Tell them. I don't know the root of it. It's just something that's just a part of me. It's just part of my soul. I failed at Worlds by half a kilo. It could have been 1,000 kilos. It wouldn't have mattered. I still failed. I failed 585.
Well, basically, here's the gist, right? At least I'm going to explain my end of things, right? As you guys know, if you've been watching my last few videos, just transitioned back into sumo. So the last sumo deadlift session I had was just a few sets of 405 for five. And before that, I don't remember the last time I did sumo. Just really working on bringing up my conventional strength belt list. But today I made a special exception to kind of say YOLO max with James, because he's coming down here and he wanted to max. So obviously if we both max together, like all our fucking high energy and stuff. So came in and
both failed together.
But as I was warming up, I could like tell my form like wasn't how it was supposed to be. I was having a little bit too much hyperextension and just my form was a little off. And the way it gets better is just me doing more and more of the movements to like re-ingrain the motor pathways to get him back how I want him to. But I managed to pull 585 in the sloppy ass shitty form with my knees collapsing. But I still pulled it and it was clean. And that's about 90 more pounds.
I pulled it off the ground. I almost locked it out. Come on, give me a little bit of credit. Give me like a B minus.
If I gave him a little slap and I was there yelling at him like I did on his third attempt, holy shit, he tried.
Coulda, shoulda, would've. The thing is, when I, like, you saw the five plates I pulled was like, it was nothing. It was just, it was so easy. So I had so much confidence going into the 585. But when I go to pull a weight that I've already pulled in the past and I know I can pull, my form is just, it's way better because I have the confidence that I can pull it. When I go up to 585, even if I feel wicked strong, it's still a notorious 585 that I failed like 1,000 times. And I don't know what goes on in my brain, but like my form breaks down, my backgrounds, I pull it off the floor. You saw like I pulled it like past my knees, so close to locking out, and I just couldn't do it. It just wasn't there. It's because my back was rounded. With like 500 and like any weight, like 545, if I pull 545, it's gonna be slower off the ground, but it's gonna be way cleaner, and I'll be able to lock it out better.
You let a drone enthusiast who doesn't really even deadlift outpull you by 90 pounds, James, and you're like an IBF wannabe world champion, James. I would seriously contemplate like suicidal thoughts if I were you. And I'm just speaking as a friend. Another thing I want to say, right? I didn't even feel my pre-workout. Literally didn't even feel it. It's just one of those situations right now where I'm gonna have insomnia and I'm not gonna be able to sleep all night, but I never got any like initial adrenaline rush or anything like that.
I totally did on the warm-ups. That's why 405 and 495 just moved at like RP zero.
Oh, but another thing, right? Because if you look, like James kind of brought this up, if you look at everything up to like 585 or up to 500 that we pulled, all of his pulls were just significantly faster, but I ended up like pulling the heavier weight, and that's just kind of a difference in form. James likes to pull all like explosive and shit, and when you're really exploding on the sumo deadlift or just any deadlift in general, it's a lot easier to lose tightness and shit.
It's literally just 585. 585 is a cursed weight.
Yeah.
Like I'll pull 600 before I pull 585.
For me, I noticed that I just like to stay really calm and collected with my deadlift, just really focus on like the mental cues of the form and just come up. I like to be on pre-workout because when I'm on pre-workout, I just, my baseline, without even psyching myself up, I'm very energized and like my central nervous system is primed and ready, and anything I touch, I'm just gonna be really strong. So I have basically the enough norepinephrine in my synapses in my brain that I would if I was not on pre-workout hyping myself up. I have that consistently, so I don't need to psych myself up, but I have the energy of a psych up, so I can focus on my form and mental cues, and I just pull weight like that. But Jason...
That's how Dan pulls weight, but me, Jason...
James is a scumbag, and he likes to rip shit off the ground.
Yeah, dude.
Scumbag. Terrible person.
No, but you can't use the hashtag pull sumo eat butt if you do the nice slow sumo patient off the ground. If you eat
that's just how you do it.
If you eat ass, you gotta rip it off the ground. God, you gotta rip it up and fail 585.